recording. So today is October, 15th, and today we are going to power through a power hour together. So the intent here, if you're not on live, you can use this recording and do a power hour with us later on with the recording. It'll be perfect. And I'll keep that event page up and open so you can, go through each step of a power hour, like your follow-ups, your invites, your connections, how you interact in your challenge groups, things like that. You can go back and you can check out the posts in the event page just for some tips and just listen to the tips that we share too along the way. It's really just supposed to be laid back, even low key, and just to do power hour together and to see how we do it. And it's funny, everybody does their power a little bit differently. So it might not be the same exact way you do it today, but try it and give it, a go. So in the event page right now, I would encourage you to be in there as we go along. I just posted the daily action plan in there. So the first step, honestly, guys, to having a good power hour, in my opinion, is to make sure you have some sort of way that you're tracking your business. And you just need some intent for your day. And there's nothing more powerful, in my opinion, as you do. If you sit down and have this focus hour, you can get a whole lot of stuff done. So when I sit down every day, I think about my action plan. So just for take a second as I'm kind of chatting, and just if you have this printed, that's great. If not, take the ideas that you see here, like have today's schedule. What are you doing the morning, the night, the evening? What you're grateful for, things like that. And don't forget too, we're products of the product. So we need to be keeping track that we've had our Shakeology, our workout, our personal development, and our me time. That's really, really important. And then think about where you want to focus your social media posts today. Are you going to share your workout? Are you going to share you drinking your shake? Are you going to throw out some motivation? Don't forget life too. It's like that 80-20 balance, 80% of just life and you, and 20% something with Beachbody. So always keep that in mind too. It's easy to just get in the trap of like, oh, I'm going to share this about my Beachbody and this and this and this. And just also the three things that you want to accomplish today. Maybe that's just to get through your power hour. That might be your first thing. A lot of days I put that on there, to get through power hour, because that's important and that's the most important part of my business. And look at how much power hour, if you look at the bottom of the tracker, power hour is a ton of tasks, right? So saying that three must happens is your power hour, you're going to get a lot done. So think about that. And maybe then you're going to, another must happen, you need to organize your challenge group that's starting on Monday. And then maybe another thing you need to do is, for me, I need to go to the post office before it closes at noon to get something sent out to my challengers, because that's important. That's a big part of my business. That's the three things I must do today. Hopefully that little action plan helps you, and that will just kind of get us started today. For sure. And what we're going to do then is I'm just going to work through this list, and we'll talk about what each step involves in Power Hour. So anybody have any questions before we really get started, or comments to add or anything, feel free to hop in at any time as we go through. All right. So if you look at your power hour checklist, and I said earlier, everybody kind of works through these in different orders. You could work at these. This doesn't mean too, guys, a lot of people, I know that you just in your schedule, in your busy day, you don't always have like 1 hour that you can sit down and do all this. You might do this at different times of the day, but you just need to make sure you get all these things checked off, right? So the first thing on that checklist is to check your online office, and that's really important. So I want everyone to go ahead and just, if you haven't today yet, go ahead and log on to your Team Beachbody online office. I'm doing this right with you, just saying on my screen. And online office, and you want to log in and you want to just check out. The thing I always look at first is over on the left side of your online office is your where they tell you if you have new customers and things like that. That, I think, is the first thing that you want to check. You want to see if anybody you'd sent a link to finally ordered, things like that. So new customers, new coaches in your network too. If you look at new coaches, it shows you not only your coaches that you've added as discount or working. It also will show you anybody in your downline. So, you know, like Callie's new coaches will show up in my report and things like that. So it's in your organization. So then you can kind of keep an eye too on, you know, well, who signed up a challenger? Who is rocking it? Who's, you know, bringing new people and life to our team? So it's always good to check out. My online office is going really slow at the moment. So I always check that first. I see if anybody has ordered. My Success Club points are finally updating. It's been like 3 days since they have. And then I always go to my downline and I check out my sponsorship drill down. And when you go into your sponsorship drill down, it's really important to look at people's projected statuses. So you want to see if your discount coaches are remaining active or not, you know, on their Shakeology. If they're red, that means they're projected inactive. So what that means, if you don't know, that means by next Thursday, if they don't have an order go out, again, their home direct order, their 90 PV, they are going to be inactive and they won't count. Like if you're working towards a rank, like a diamond rank, or if you are trying to hold your emerald rank, you know, if they don't continue that 90 PV, they're not going to count in your numbers. So if you are, you know, relying on somebody for your emerald rank right and left, one person on each, and you see that somebody's going inactive on their Shakeology, you might want to keep an eye on that or reach out to them. Just say, hey, just honestly, I don't ever say, hey, like, why didn't you order? Like, why are you delaying your Shakeology, or like put them under the bus or anything? I just connect with them, see if you can plug them back into a challenge group and get them working again with you. That's usually my approach there as far as just keeping people engaged and active. You know, if they're in a challenge group, then you're going to encourage them to keep their Shakeology. You can also always check your volume, just see how your team is producing. And I always check that out, and just to see my own personal volume as well, how I'm doing there for the week. So that's pretty much online office. You want to just check people that are active and, you know, your new customers and things like that. So yeah, does anyone else, I guess we can move on then. I think we're good to go. Is everybody good to go about your, okay, good. So online office easy. Now training groups and challenge group invites. So what I'm going to do is set my timer over here for about 10 minutes. And I know, you know, you might not be able to check. It depends, you know, what kind of training groups you're in right now, but I want you to go on your training groups, and I want you to go to today's pin post and your challenge groups too. So I want you to focus first on those pin posts and engage in those first. I'm going to do that as well. You're going to check out the pin posts and make sure that you are participating in your training groups. And if you already have been in there, you can start commenting on other people's posts as well. And you need to put value into your challengers right now for 10 minutes. I mean, you know, this probably will take you, you probably need to go back when we're done with our power hour, but we started a little late and I want to, you know, make sure that we get through everything this morning. But I want you to go in your challenge groups right now and add some value to them and your training groups as well. Personally, when I think about what you need to get accomplished in your power hour, it should be your business first and challengers first. So I would go to challenge groups first, start with those, make sure you connect with all your challengers this morning, and then go to your training groups, because training groups I view more as organizational business. Okay. That's like, that's growing team wise. So challengers first, ready, set, go. I'm setting my timer. I'm going to do it as well. And if anyone, while you're checking into your groups, if you want to add anything about how to add some value to those posts and things like that, that would be awesome. Just you can share what you're doing, saying any things you want to, you know, ask about. And no pressure for you to. Okay, I'm setting my timer. We're stopping in 10 minutes. And feel free to chat while we do it. I need to go to
I have to say, I love the fact that people are finding new pictures for the pin post. I'm really noticing that in the last couple groups.
Yeah.
Like people are just copying and pasting things. They're putting their own personality in it.
Mm-hmm.
My mouth is literally frozen from the shakeology right now.
You're right.
I can't even, but it's awesome. Danielle Schmidt, she's doing her first posting week in our group and she's rocking it. Like she literally has like found completely different images, but they all reflect her personality. I just love seeing
that. That's awesome. Yeah. I have to shout out to in my challenge group right now, Darianne is posting and it's her first time posting too. And she also found completely different images and things like that. So I love that too. And they're very good too. That's funny. That's really cool. Something really important to keep in mind when you're checking into your groups is just to make sure that you're just sharing in there all the time. So you know, just taking an extra second to share, you know, like how you had your Shakeology today, like just share your recipe. Like even if it's just a frozen banana and peanut butter, like just tell people that's how you made it, you know, just make sure that you are adding that value. When you make a new recipe, just post a picture of your dinner and copy paste it from wherever you found it and, you know, share that with them. And just simple things like that. And, you know, a lot of times it can just be reusing your posts from Facebook, like copy pasting them right into the challenge group just so that they feel that personal touch as well. I think that's important. Oh, and I'm going to add, I did in my challenge group, I took the idea Jerry had, the Simon Says. If you're in the Diamond internship group right now, she posted those the other day. I love those little Simon Says posts just for like extra fun. So I'm gonna go ahead and you guys can post ideas too in the event page if you have anything like that you add. Maybe Lindsay, you could post if you have a second, you could post your like your bingo boards in here and stuff. Would you mind?
Yeah.
Just so that everybody kind of, maybe then we'll have everything in one place. You know what I mean? Because you can always come back to this page. I came back to an old event we did before. So you can definitely come back to this later on. I think that would be really helpful. And I'll find Jerry's. I just have them on my desktop right now, actually, because I love them and save them from that group. So I'll get those up. Any way to, you know, if you're especially sometimes challenge groups just kind of die out like a couple weeks in and you need a way to kind of get everybody excited again. I know that's kind of the case in one of my groups right now. So I posted one of Jerry's Simon Says today.
This makes me realize how I need to organize my desktop computer.
I know. I'm like, I can't find them. I know. You should see my desk. I'm not even going to talk about what my desktop looks like right now. I have like all these dragged images. I'm like, yeah. Crazy. I need to organize for sure. I'm taking a picture of my shake right now for the challenge tracker app. How are we doing? Just checking in. Everyone's doing good. Everyone's at work. Silence is a good thing. That's like in my classroom. I'm like, okay, if everyone's quiet, it must be a good thing. Everybody's working.
This is why I struggle getting work done at my family's house, because I told them I was coming on here to do this. And so far, I've had both my mom and my younger sister out here talking to me.
Focus. Tell them to leave.
But we support her.
Get away. What's that? Jordan, so just a funny story about him. He got a speeding ticket like a couple months ago, and he refused to just pay like the $50 to, you know, get away with it or whatever. And so now he's at like DUI class this morning. Like he's like at driver safety class, and he was like complaining about it all day. I'm like, so do you learn your lesson? Like next time just pay, like buck up and just pay the money, and then you won't have to go. Like he has to spend till 5 o'clock there today. And I'm like, oh good.
Yeah, then Damon does that crap.
What?
Damon does that crap. He'd be like, well, like yeah. Maybe if I just don't go, like they'll know I'm serious. Like
This morning he like he got like dressed up, like he wore a tie to this and I'm like, why are you look like an idiot. Like why are you wearing like this is like I mean, I'm pretty sure everyone's gonna come in their sweatpants. And he's like, well, I just wanna make a statement that I am not like these other people, and I am a good, well-rounded person, and I do not deserve to be here. And I'm like, well, you were speeding and you got a ticket and you wouldn't pay the money. So that's like what you get, you know? But anyway, the moral of my story was, I'm happy today because I have a day that I won't be just, he won't distract me. I can just do my work today. So it's like not that bad. I mean, I love him to death, you know, but some days I'm like, okay, yeah, just go. Bye. See you later. Good luck. So
Damon's gone Sunday afternoon until Tuesday.
Oh afternoon. Gosh. Yeah. And isn't it like sad, but you're kind of like at the same time, you're like, oh, that will be amazing.
I have a whole list of things I'm doing.
You're like, okay, yeah. And they're like, oh, I'm gonna miss you. You're like, yeah, me too. All right, let me check on the time. We have about 2 more minutes and then we'll move along on our list.
I did want to say how sorry I am for being late.
Oh my gosh, had, like, you're fine.
22 cows out. And so we were running through the fields chasing cows.
No worries. We just were kind of talking about tracking in the beginning and just how you need to have a way to track your, you know, power hour every day. And,
okay. I am sorry though.
You did not like miss out on much at all. So
okay.
We're good.
I literally just like realize how I can't have like two things going on at once, like hearing people talk and then like doing like writing, because I just was looking at Brooke's like meal that she has in her challenge group.
Yeah.
And it was like pasta, and I said, and I was writing, you look so amazing on it. And like you say it all.
I know.
It's like a piece of cake.
Like, I love it. Live power hours I love, but like I personally, like since I'm talking and like posting and stuff, I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna have to do it more later. But I love it. Like I like just talking about like what we should do, you know, and like okay. I've been trying to post in my like free group now for like 5 minutes and I still haven't gotten the post done. So it's okay. Did anyone else run a free group this week? Just side note. Anybody else?
No. Yeah, Chelsea Morgan and I ran one.
This time.
We did Crock-Pot.
Yeah, how did it go?
I think it went well. I actually, since I was like stormed into my hotel room all week until yesterday, I actually did all of the recipes on the day that I posted them and did a video.
Yeah.
I couldn't do them live because I didn't have anyone to help me hold the camera, and it just became. So I made videos instead, though, and I actually had a better.
Yeah, next time, what I did in mine was I gave them like a meal plan with all the recipes in the beginning of the week, so they could like go out and get them all. But I didn't do that, that hike, eat them, have them daily with, I don't know. I found that my fitness free group was a lot more interactive than my eating one. But I mean, that's kind of like, I don't know. It's a little simpler. So I don't know. I think in the future I'll stick to like a workout focused one. I think it just engages people more, but I did get a lot more people liking my page from it, and just, people in my funnel. So that's always good. All right. So we did training group check-ins. We did challenge group check-ins. Now, replying to your commenters and your likers and messaging your commenters and likers. What does that mean? That's really simple. We're just going to do it for like 2 minutes. All you do is go to your Facebook page or your like page, whatever you work off of. And you just, if anybody has commented on your pictures, you go back and comment. I only do this. So one little cool trick is if you post something on your Facebook, like your transformation or, your all call and somebody comments on it. And if you wait to comment, I learned this at a Super Saturday once. If you wait to comment to the next morning on it, or you don't immediately comment back, if you kind of wait it out, then what happens is your post is going to start, it's going to reappear in people's news feeds, because it's going to, like, you know how when people comment on a post, they says like someone like Lindsay Maloney commented on Callie's post, then even if it was a post from yesterday, it re-pops up in my newsfeed. So it's a little trick. So you don't always have to give your post immediate feedback. You could do it a couple hours later, especially like your recipe post. You could comment back like a couple hours later, or a transformation especially, then it brings it back to people's feed later on. So just take like 2 minutes, go to your Facebook page and see if you need to respond to anybody's. And I actually didn't take my own, my picture from this morning. I immediately commented back to Danielle, actually one of the coaches on our team, because she told me about Victoria's Secret sale on my post, and I got really excited. But you can go back through and just see if there's anybody that, you want to comment on. If people tell you look amazing in your transformation pictures, make sure you thank them and just give them some encouraging words back. That's really important. When people comment on that, that builds a little bit of credibility, and then it shows up in their feed too. So definitely, it sounds really silly and simple, but you need to make sure you engage with the people that post on your Facebook. So don't just throw up content and then not answer, if that makes sense. And then too, you can, if people have commented, the next step on your little checklist is to go ahead and comment on 3 to 3+ posts. So this is your permission right now for me to go and scroll your Facebook feed. And I know that we try to not do that, but if you set your timer for 2 minutes only, you can just scroll through your Facebook and try to just find okay, I just found this picture on my wall of this girl who I went to college with who literally has the most adorable new baby, and she just posted a picture this morning, and I'm going to comment. I'm going to just say, oh my gosh, adorable. And I'm just going to, be present on their page just by doing that. Easy, guys. Think about, babies, easy to comment on, right? Or if someone posted, a new profile picture and it's really pretty, just say you look beautiful. Something simple like that. And then when you comment on their things, they're gonna start seeing your posts pop up on their wall. You can even just like their posts, love them, easy, okay? All right. So everybody good there? That's pretty simple. Now we can move to the fun things. The message three friends. It's the hey girl message. Guys, this is your connecting, okay? So connecting is honestly, guys, like the it's really, 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 I can't explain enough, part of your business, okay? You can't just expect, especially when you've been in this for a while and you're talking to complete strangers, right? You can't just go in there and be like, hey, I'm a Beachbody coach and you should have a challenge group. Like, that is not going to work, okay? That might have worked for a while with your best, closest friends, but it's not going to work anymore. You need to build some relationships. So the invites all start with reconnecting, connecting or reconnecting. Okay, so you need to reach out to people and send them that simple, hey girl message. So I'm gonna pop up a post in the page right now about connecting to give you some ideas. And then if you guys just wanna share, I want you right now, it says to send out three. So you're gonna send three hey girl messages. Now, how I do that, is I just go to the people that I've recently added on Facebook, and I will send them a message and just say, hey girl, and I'll post that right underneath what I just posted. I'll show you my message. It's really, really simple. It's literally a hey girl. It says, hey girl, I just wanted to reach out and send you a quick message since we recently became friends on Facebook. How have you been? So you see, I had a question. I find that really helpful. You just don't want to say, hey, I'm so glad we're friends on Facebook now. Have a great day. Well, they're not going to know what to do. They're just going to be like, okay, so this random girl is just messaging me. Weird. And then guys, a lot of times I hear like, well, what do you do when they like, I don't think I know you. And I'm like, you know what? I don't know you either, but we had a ton of mutual friends on Facebook. And then I try to figure out like how we had a ton of mutual friends on Facebook, if that makes sense. So that I can figure out like, okay, like, yeah, how do we know each other? How can we connect with one another? So I just go to their page and creep a little bit. Normally it's the case of like, they went to my high school, or they currently, you know, they're from my area, or a lot of people are from my sister's college or something. And I just say, oh, like I see you go to Allegheny. My sister just graduated there last year. And then they're like, oh yeah. And then they know her, you know, like, so it's nice. Or they might go to Westminster where I went to school, and I just say, oh, it looks like you go to Westminster. Like, are you loving it? Like, I just, you know, I just turn that like that weird message back that sometimes people will send, be like, don't know you. I just say, yeah, you know what? We don't know each other, but I saw we had a bunch of mutual friends and it looks like you are a really cool girl. And I just talked to them. So honestly, you just got to get past like the whole like weirdness of sending out a message to somebody you don't know. So that's that. Another thing you can do, it kind of tells you here, I'm going to skip one, but interact in your interest groups. So that can be anything, like an interest group, something that you're interested in life. Like it could be like, you might be a part of, like Callie could be a part of like some like medical school, I don't know, like support group, or like, I'm on a lot of pages with teachers, just like teacher tips and stuff like that, where people will post them there, like asking questions or sharing teaching ideas. And just, you know, you can be interactive in those kind of groups, things that you just like style, whatever you're into, and start to kind of just comment on people's posts. That's all that takes. And then, you know, from there, like there are a few people, I don't spend a lot of time in interest groups, but if there's somebody who's always commenting on my posts, or I think they, you know, there's a few people that I'll think, okay, yeah, I'm going to friend request them on Facebook because we talked a lot on the interest page, then you can send them a friend request too. And then they're going to see your fitness post. I never just like go in there and like invite everybody in there or anything like that. But, you know, that you could find friends that way. Another thing, I think, yeah, adding friends, we'll talk about that in a second, how I add friends. Another awesome thing, guys, is just connecting with people, the hey girls. You can do that with your birthdays too. So you can head to whoever's birthday it is on Facebook. I talk about this all the time. So some of you have heard this a million times. I talk about people's birthdays on Facebook, and I just go to their, I just go to the birthdays tab over on the side. And I go down the line of everybody's birthday. It is that day. And I just write on their wall. And then I go underneath of everybody's it is today. It shows you whose birthday was yesterday. You've already written on their wall, just like a simple message, like happy birthday, have a great day. But then I send them a personal message the next day. And it's a really quick and easy way to connect with a lot of people. And I just say, hey, how was your birthday yesterday? And I ended up questioning again. I just say, did you do anything fun to celebrate? Easy. So does anybody want to share their connecting tools or ideas? Are you doing similar things?
So with my connections, I kind of also base those off of my old, like I will go back through my old messages and see who's kind of like stale, who I haven't talked to, and then I really interact a lot on their Facebook page for a couple days straight and then do that reconnection message so that they've seen me, and then maybe I show up on their timeline because I was interacting on their Facebook page and then go back into it. But I've noticed that was one thing I totally had fallen out of during my busy season of going back to work and stuff. I had stopped connecting. Mm-hmm. And I could tell everything changed in my personal attitude. I wasn't feeling like an authentic coach, and I wasn't feeling confidence. And that's it's everything. It feels so good to be, like, you know, just social. So that's where I've really been trying to dive back in and get back on the train.
Yeah. For me too, like, I'm considering running a half marathon in the spring. And I've just been like thinking of people that I know are like really good runners. I heard like they post running pictures on Facebook, and I'm like, oh, I'm gonna just connect with them and be like, do you have any tips? Like, should I do it? You know, like, and it makes them feel like confident in themselves, because I reached out to them and was like, you know, you're really inspiring, and you know, I just look up to you as a runner. And, you know, like, that feels really good. And when you can connect with people over your interests too, like, in, you know, I'm never going to probably talk to them about Beachbody, to be honest. I just wanted, honestly, I want some tips for myself, and I want them to feel good about what they do too, and to know that they inspire me in another way. So, you know, think about different kind of people too that you can, you know, connect with. I think that's important.
Well, that's something I actually really struggle with. Maybe you guys can help me. Yeah. My Facebook feed and my ones who immediately pop up are all people who I see almost every day because of, you know, having their kids in class, or it's like the other coaches. And I kind of feel like I lose the other, like, I was just trying to find how many friends I have. I have 1,224 friends, and I swear I see like 12 of them on Facebook. Like, what do you, how do you, why?
I don't know how to do it, but I think there's a way to filter your newsfeed. Isn't that true? I'm going to look at update now. I know Allie Van Arsdale knows how to do that. And
there's a way to filter out, because normally, like Lisa said, the newsfeed brings like things that have actions or comments on it to your top, or things that you've commented and liked on a lot will come to the top. So like, if you're commenting and liking on other people's stuff, their stuff's going to keep coming to the top. There's a way to filter, turn it so that it's in chronological order, no matter what, no matter who's there to is on it.
That'd be nice, because that's what I see. It's the same thing over and over from the same person over and over.
I did that. Let me see if I can remember how I did it. I think Allie's the one who taught me how to do it a while back, but let me see.
You know, I bet there's some video on YouTube even, because a lot of coaches talk about it, and I just have never done it. Like, a lot of people, they don't want to see other coaches post. I see your posts in Challenge Group, and then I see it on your wall, and then I see it on your like page. I'm like, okay, like, I don't need to see it 3 times. Like, that's great. And it's great to see that and like encourage one another and like each other's posts and all that. But like, at the same time, you can also get totally sucked into like comparison game when you're all you're seeing is on your Facebook wall is coach, 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 or you know, like all you see is Beachbody on your wall, and you're like, oh my god, like where is everyone else?
Right.
So a lot of coaches use that, and that's a really good thing to bring up. You know, I love that. That's great. What's that?
I'm sorry. I feel the same way because I have like literally 1,600 Facebook friends. I never see any guys post. I have not seen a guy's post forever.
Me either.
And it's like, gosh, like I would like to see some other stuff.
I know.
Usually a guy's post is like funny or something, and I'm like,
and then we talk about like, oh, we never invite guys. We'll wonder why we never even see them on our face.
We never interact with them, and they don't interact with my stuff either. I had a guy like my recipe post last night, and I was like, oh my god, like where did you come from? I'm like, you like food too? Like I just
speaking of guys, real quick, there's a first year medical student at VCOM that's a guy, that's a coach as of like a month ago.
Who is he?
I don't know. I reached out to him just to say like, hey, do you realize I'm a fourth year? Like let's chat, let's strategize, you know, or whatever. And he won't respond to me. So I don't know.
I would love to connect with him just to have another coach in the area, you know?
Right. So he didn't respond to my message last week. So I don't know. He like
Saturdays together and stuff. That'd be really cool. Okay. So we're going to get to the meat of this now. This is like the most important part of your power hour is you're adding, you're inviting, and you're following up. So let's talk about those things. Adding friends is so simple. Like we're not taking more than 5 minutes to do this. So at the top of your Facebook page, guys, like there is a little tab. So it says your name, your little profile picture, the home button. And then there's that little like two people thing, the friend request thing. Click on that right now. And literally, like, don't pull back. Just look at the people you may know. Look at who Facebook's suggesting you that you're be friends with. And honestly, like, if you have 50 mutual friends, you have something in common or a group of people in common, friend request them right now. If you have more than 50 mutual friends, I mean, that's, like, a no-brainer to me. if they look cute, if they look like somebody you would want to talk to and interact with perhaps, add them. Like don't overthink this. If you have 30, 40 mutual friends, like there's going to be some way that you could connect with that person. So I mean, I add a ton of people on my Facebook. I'm constantly adding friends. And I used to sit through this when I first started coaching and I would like scroll through and like kind of like evaluate everybody that I might be know. Like I'm like, I don't know. Oh no, they kind of look scared. I'm not gonna invite them. Well, hello. That's not a good thing. You don't know who could be your next like superstar coach, or you don't know who could be like the next like top coach of Beachbody. Like reach out, like just friend request them. If you have 50 mutual friends, there's definitely a reason and some way that you can connect with them. Another little thing I like to do to add friends is, okay, if you go to, I'll show you, like, if you go to, so I'm just thinking, like, I have really good luck with people from my high school. I think it's because they remember me as somebody totally different. So when I connect with people from the high school, they're kind of, like, intrigued by me, and they're, like, oh, wow, like, yeah, she looks, you know, she looks so different. She looks like, you know, they're like, wow, like, and they talk to me more, and they're interested. So I've had really good luck connecting with and working with people from high school. So knowing that, I just go, and I'll actually, like, show you guys this for a second. Let me see my Facebook page for a second. I'm not going to keep this on forever, but I just, like, search Pine Richland, and I pretty much already added everybody from my personal class, but I might go to the Pine Richland class of like 2007, which is 2 years before I graduated. And you can go, they have 220 members, and I just click on that, and then you can scroll through, and I've added a lot of these people already, and you can add, like you can add them as a friend right here. So easy. Like, And I recognize names of these people, which is cool too. Cause then you're like, okay, yeah, like I kind of actually, I don't really know her, but I think we, you know, like I remember her name, you know, how like from high school, you remember people's names and you like, you know, like, you kind of remember, oh, I actually, this Alyssa girl I was in choir with, I actually really do remember her. So it helps you just, Samantha Lerda, I know her too. Yeah. See, so there's like all these people, I don't really know her, but there's these people in here that like I could definitely make a good connection with once they accept my prayer request. So that's just a little idea that I have there. You can also go to like, if you go to your friends and you go to even like a recently added, like if you go to somebody that you became friends with, I'm just doing recently added because it'll probably be more luck. Like I can click on this person. Okay. And this is somebody I added recently. I can go to her friends. And then if you click the more button, there's this people you may know. So if you know her and you had a ton of mutual friends with her, like look at this. Like I have two, I'm not sure I'm gonna friend request this person, but we do have 270 mutual friends. So I mean, I'm not sure. I mean, I probably just should, but I do like to add girls more. Okay, so Sam Waterman, 170 mutual friends. Like, okay, like she looks really sweet and fun and like somebody that I could work with and talk with and connect with. Courtney's, I actually know her. So you can do that, okay? So just some really ideas. I think people overthink for sure. You overthink adding people as friends and it's, don't do that. Like stop overthinking it. Just like invite them. Just go. Okay.
I especially do that people you may know thing to people that are brand new challengers for me or, you know, someone that was kind of on the fence. And then I go and find the people they may under the people you may know, because then if I start inviting their friends, then when they go out for drinks, they're going to be like, oh yeah, that Cali girl, she had invited me to her group. Let's do it together.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Exactly. That's perfect. All right. So now we need to, what do we need to do? Oh, so make sure there's three lines there. So once they accept your friend request, make sure you track this and you write their three names down. That way, what I do for people that add me as a friend, and about I set up a follow-up for a week. And in a week, I'm going to follow up with the people that added me as a friend on Facebook. So for a week, I'm going to try to just like on their posts if I can, if it pops up on my newsfeed. I'm gonna maybe go to their page once they've requested me and just kind of scroll through it, check them out, like something to kind of stay present. And then in 1 week, I send them that hey girl message. So that's where my connects come from. The people that have added me 1 week later. So 1 week from today, if you had three people today, then in a week, next Saturday, you're gonna have three people to connect with. Does that make sense? So it just keeps me really organized and make sure that I am going ahead and talking to everybody that I do add, even if they, whether they message me back or not, I send them a message, you know, a week from today. So anybody I added today will be followed up with a week later with a hey girl message, a simple connect message. All right. I hope that is helpful too. All right. So we're going to now go to it's the most important part of your power hour, the inviting. So guys, we can't hold back on inviting. It's so key to our business. We need to just go out there and share what we have to offer. And you need, when you go and approach your invite, so one thing that I've learned along the way, I used to send this big, long message, this big, long paragraph message about everything I do as a coach, and it was really super long, and nobody read it, probably, but you need to just keep it short, sweet, and simple. You know, something like, I don't know, just something like, hey, girl, I'll post my invite. What mine says right now is, my current one says, sorry, I'm looking for it. It says, hey, and I connect with them first. I just say, hey, I hope you're having a wonderful weekend. How did your exam go this week? Like I may have talked to somebody about a test or something. And then I send that message. And then right after I just send them a message and say, I just wanted to reach out to you today about my new health and fitness accountability group. Fall back to you that I'll be starting on Monday and that I would love for you to join in on the fun. would you be interested in learning more? So simple, short, and sweet. I didn't really tell them a lot about what the group was about. You know, I leave it up to them. I say, you know, would you be interested in learning more? And again, just like our connects, just like our other messages, it just leaves them the ball in their court and gives them a call to action about what to say. So something to keep in mind. And I would love to hear about your inviting strategies too. And so right now I want you to set out to do 3 to 5 invites. We'll take about, we're going to run out of time here, but we'll take about, I don't want to go too far past 9 o'clock because I do have another call, but we'll take about 5 minutes just to maybe send 3 invites.
Hey, Liesl, will you post what you just said?
I absolutely will. I'm working on that right this second.
Okay, cool. I just feel like a lot of people do word vomit, and that's a very quick way to...
Yep, I'm sending it right now. I'm just kind of like... I want it to look good for people that hop back in here later and didn't hear me. I hope. This morning I was saying earlier, I sent some invites earlier, and I just said, I hope your weekend is off to a great start. Do you have any plans?
This is so unrelated, but back to this other topic, guys, I noticed that, I went through on my friends list and I had a lot of like outstanding friend requests and I unrequested them all. And you have to go back several times into clicking on the little 2 people at the top because it'll only bring you up so many that you've requested. So you have to keep continuously doing it until it's gone. But it gave me so many actual people that I know because I was getting all these mutual friends of like one person and I'm like, where are the people that I actually might know?
Yeah.
And by actually taking that off of there, it generated an entire group of new people that I would know.
Yeah, I did that too. I was letting them like hang out in there.
Yeah.
It was like, okay, and let me tell you who they are for me. They are like all my students. So I'm like, and it's just like, and parents and stuff. I'm like, ugh. And I was just letting them hang out. Like, I didn't want to like not, I don't know. I don't know why. My students, I should have immediately been like, no. But.
Oh, yeah. I'm talking about people that I requested.
Sorry.
So if you clear those out of requests that you've sent out to people, it gives you like an entire new.
Gotcha. Okay. Gotcha. Yeah. Sorry.
No, it's okay.
Right. Did someone put something in the chat? Oh, Callie had to go. Okay. So is that helpful, what I posted in the page? I just posted the message. I just think, like, honestly, like, all this, like, everything a part of your power hour, like, we just overthink, you know? Like, it's simple. And, guys, when I send that message, like, I switch up that beginning part, like, that connecting piece, like, hope you're having a great weekend, or, you know, like, oh, I hope some so-and-so went well, or, you know, you had a great time at this party, or, you know, anything that I know about them from connecting with them prior. You know, I just, other than that, like, that message that I send, like, the, about my challenge group, that's a copy paste, you know, like, easy, and you can get those invites, like, you can get 35 invites out in, like, 2 minutes if you wanted to, and it's just really important, too, to make sure that you, so after that hey girl message, like, I talked to them kind of for, like, a week again, so, like, I sent my initial invite, like, let's say today I sent somebody an invite to be my friend on Facebook, or a friend request. I send them a friend request today, and a week later, I connect with them through that hey girl, and I hope that they message me back, but whether they did or not, whether we talked a week or not, I invite them the following week. So I've talked to somebody, like, for 3 weeks, really. You know, it's like a 3-week process from when they accepted my friend request to when I send them an invite, and in that time period, I try to connect with them, talk to them, be present on their Facebook page so that they're seeing my posts. And just, you know, it's like, it's a process really. And it's not something like you friend request somebody one day and they're your challenger the next. So, that's just kind of how I map it out. And it's a lot of tracking for sure, but, so I'm going to jump ahead, I think, today, because I know we're all focusing on hitting Success Club right now. So I'm going to jump over that, inviting to the coaching opportunity just for our sake of time. I don't want to put that on the back burner. Like, we can talk about that on another call for sure. But I want to take some time for the follow-up. So I'm going to post some follow-up ideas. Also just some things, about a lot of times in our follow-up, we find objections too, like reasons why they don't want to join the group. Right. So I'll post some helpful objection tips too, but the follow-up is like the bread and butter. Like, people are going to tell you no, probably like on average, like 3 to 5 times before they say yes. So you have to build credibility and trust. So following up with someone is okay. So we're going to wrap up today just with that follow up. And honestly, like 75% of challenge packs, there's a statistic out there that 75% of challenge packs or coach signups are done through a follow up. I know personally I was a follow up. So, Allie messaged me, you know, in I think December, and I just completely ignored her message. But you honestly, I did start watching her posts. Like, I, you know, she did start coming up in my feed, and I kind of was like, oh, what does she do? You know, like, what is going on here? And, I just, then she followed up with me, and I remember ignoring her again and again. And finally I was interested. Like, I kind of got back to a place where I was like, I need to do something to like change and keep my, like, my progress and my, you know, my journey continuing. And I knew like what she was doing now. So I finally read her messages and responded back to her. So just something to keep in mind, the follow-up is so, so key. So just remember to do that. I'm going to post right now some ideas. If you guys want to share yours too, and just talk about your follow-up experience. So you can just like when you follow up, I just do like a reconnect first. I just say, hey, I just want to follow up on our conversation from, you know, it might be a situation where you invite someone, they said they were interested, and then the conversation fell short. So I say something like, I just wanted to follow up about our conversation you're having on Wednesday. What questions do you have? So I ask them a question again. And then sometimes too, you have to follow up again. And I just say, hey, good morning. I still haven't heard back from you yet. Please feel free to shoot me any questions your way. I just don't want to miss out on that opportunity to work with you. Just make them feel like that they, you know, they are valued, right? That you value them. And just to remind them that you believe in them, right? Just remind them that you really want to help them start this journey. You know, not like, hey, like, come on, you need to order any of my Success Club points. Like, never, you never want to have that, like, that feel there, right? So you just want to, you want them to be excited. Even this morning I was sending a message like, I am getting so excited for my challenge group to start on Monday. And I know you are interested, and I so hope that you join us, and that, you know, please let me know what questions you have. Just kind of put some urgency, like, oh, my group's starting tomorrow. Like, come on. Like, do you want to be part of it or not? But it sounds really, really true and genuine. Something too, I was totally getting lost. Like, I was losing people a lot of times. I was just like starting conversations with them. They were super interested. And then I would get lost. Like, we're really lucky in Beachbody to have a mobile business, right? We have something that we can take with us everywhere we go. And sometimes we message somebody back and we're like at the traffic light. I mean, I hope you're not. I shouldn't say that, but I might do that. Like, I might message people sometimes when I'm sitting in traffic, and that's probably illegal. But, you know, like, or you might be in the middle of the grocery store and somebody messages you, and you read their message, and then you don't respond right away, and you lose them. That's the facts of life, guys. That happens. Just keep in mind, like, to make sure to help you keep track of people, I'm trying to post right now a really easy to use tracker of your challenger perspectives. And it just, you write their name down and keep track of them. So that you can, and what I do then every few days, I just kind of go through my list and update it. And then, why is this not working? It's driving me crazy. You just update it. I just go through the list and make sure that I have been I've followed up with those people that I was talking to earlier in the week. Does that make sense? All right, hopefully that works eventually. Let me try again. Leave. So obviously we didn't have like the perfect power hour ever, but I just hope that it did help you, you know, as far as our timing. We got a little distracted and chatty, but I hope it gave you some tips and you can go back, you know, into this page and you can really you could re-listen to this call and kind of pause it and do each step, you know, along the way. And really have a more focused intent power hour where you can work on your business and take those tips. And I'll leave the event page open, so the event page will be available to you as well. And then that way you can use that just to kind of remember our tips that we talked about. You know, a lot of times I'll hear things on calls and then I'll be like, wait, what did she say? Well, there you go. It's going to be there for you. Just on that page for, you know, until I'm not going to delete the group or anything. So they'll be there forever. You can go ahead and grab those resources and work through that. Okay. How's that sound, Danielle? Was this helpful? Yeah. Just of how managing your time and going through the power hour and sticking to that list too.
My power hour used to be really good. And then it like way deteriorated into like stuff I shouldn't be doing because I could. And
yeah, I think I don't have for me, I just have to have that list in front of me. Like I need that like checklist to help me stay on track. And then too, just the, you know, I also set a timer normally like for my hour and I just like make sure it's like a race against the clock. Ooh, how much can I get done today? And I like go for it, you know? So that's how I do it too. So
yeah.
All right. Well, I hope it was helpful, and I'll post some other little resources you as I think about them. And it's hard to like we said, multitasking is definitely not my thing. Like trying to talk to you while posting, while doing my invites, I'm like, this is crazy. But hopefully, I'll keep posting in there so you guys can have some good hours. All right. Any questions? All right, I'll post the recording for sure too, so you can go back and listen to this and kind of do power hour alongside of us. And I love your precious baby. Hello. I want to like jump through the computer and just like squeeze him. All right. Have a good Saturday, everyone. Bye.
Bye.